Hello and welcome to Amazing Mind, the HMI web TV talk show that introduces you to all sorts of interesting people and topics related to the subconscious mind. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, hypnotherapist, HMI instructor, and your host. Today we have an amazing guest who's going to talk to us about how we can better nurture adolescent girls, not only in our private practices, but also in our lives. Please help me welcome Dr. Cheryl Feldman. Now, Dr. Feldman is my wonderful, one of my best friends, and she sent me a lecture that she had given to the Vista Del Mar Children and Family Services in Los Angeles, California, and I was very impressed with that lecture. I think you gave it to interns who are studying to become PhD psychologists like yourself. Some of the statistics were pretty scary. Can you share them with us?
Absolutely. They are pretty scary. Here are some in no particular order. One in four girls are depressed, clinically depressed, and there's a rise in the suicide rate starting at age 10.
Wow.
And peaking at 24. So all through adolescence, there's more and more suicides. One in four girls has or will be in an abusive relationship. And with body image, starting at 13, about 50% of girls are unhappy with their weight. By the time you get to 18 years old, it's 80% of girls are unhappy with their weight. And 80% of 10-year-olds are on a diet. 10-year-olds should not be on a diet. 80% of 10-year-olds are so unhappy with their weight that they're actually on a diet. 8 million women in America have eating disorders, and of those, about 90% are adolescents.
Wow. Now, this sounds fairly new because I'm 51 and I don't remember any of this when I was growing up. Is this something new? Has it been like this all throughout history?
Absolutely not. This is a 20th century phenomenon and now continuing into the 21st century. About 100 years ago in the 1800s and 1900s, actually close to 200 years ago now, the expectations and view of girls and adolescents was very, very different. There was a focus on character, there was a focus on internal traits and on conduct, not on appearance.
Well, was it pretty rigid? And what were these expectations 200 years ago?
They were that girls would behave in a way that is moral and serious and dignified and other-focused, and, you know, any girl who was primping in front of a mirror was disapproved of. It wasn't okay to be concerned about your looks. There are a couple of diary entries that I'll share with you.
I'd love to hear them.
They're basically New Year's resolutions, and in 1892, the girl wrote, "I want to be more restrained, more dignified, work seriously, show interest in others, not talk about myself." And 100 years later, in 1982, the girl wrote, "With my babysitting money, I'm going to lose weight, and I'm going to get new lenses, and a new haircut and makeup, and better clothes and accessories."
Huge difference.
The contrast is amazing.
What do you attribute it to?
I attribute it to the societal messages that are just bombarding us. We are, in the last 200 years, we have come into the information age, and at this point, we are so flooded with images and messages, and the messages that have evolved over the last century are have gone from the internal lives of women to the external visual aspect of who women are. And everything you see is about body and looks and skin and size and shape and sexuality and dress and clothing.
Wow. Well, I want to make this a little more personal, both in your practice and in the other psychologists that you supervise. What kind of problems are you seeing coming into the offices, psychology offices, of adolescent girls?
Well, there are many problems. As I mentioned, there are abusive relationships.
With parents or with boyfriends?
With boyfriends.
What do you mean?
Well, there are emotionally controlling relationships and there are physically controlling and abusive relationships. There's also a lot of substance abuse and pressure towards substance abuse, and a more recent trend is cutting. And cutting is becoming much more common, just cutting one's own skin and It is a release of pain. It's a release of emotional pain,
uh-huh.
as is using substances.
Yes.
Because there is so much pain and so much confusion to be in a world where 100, 200 years ago, there were codes of conduct. There were rules for how girls were supposed to be. Now, we don't agree with what those rules were.
Yeah.
I grew up in a totally different era, but we didn't replace them with anything. We threw them out,
yes.
good riddance, but we have not developed a new set of rules and guidelines that girls can follow about how to discover who you are, how to discover, how to make choices in a world that's so full of choices and so many of them can uh-huh. be destructive to you in one way or another, how to make good choices for yourself. We also, 100 years ago, we had systems, we had organizations in society that guided and protected girls. There still is the Girl Scouts. There
yes.
were Campfire Girls, there was the YWCA, and mm-hmm. lots of other organizations that were run by women. The girls were mentored by older girls and women. They had a sense of community, a sense of identity,
mm-hmm.
and they were guided through the complexities of life, and they had a sense of purpose. We don't have those kind of containing institutional structures anymore.
What about the family? What's going on in families? We don't have the institutions. We have so much information coming in that's all body focused. But what can families do to help to protect our daughters and our sisters and our nieces?
Well, before I get to what we can do, I kind of want to talk more about the other issues that have come into being.
No, I'd love to hear it. Yes.
One of them is that physical maturation is happening earlier.
Really?
Girls are actually coming into puberty, into physical maturity earlier than they used to.
Is it because of nutrition? Is it because of hormones?
Nobody knows. So, I mean, it's, you know, the question, it might be better nutrition, it might be hormones in our meat. Nobody knows. But what's happening is that menstruation 100 years ago used to happen between 14 and 16 years of age. Now it's happening between 10 and 12 years of age. And sometimes as young as 8 years old. So you've got a 10-year-old who suddenly is developing curves, who has a body that men and boys around her are looking at and responding to.
How can she,
and a 10-year-old is not equipped.
How can you handle that?
Because emotional maturity has not kept pace.
Yes.
Our emotional development is the same as it's always been. It has mm-hmm. not sped up. Part of another developmental issue that has been around for a long time but is in a different context now mm-hmm. is what we call separation and individuation.
What do you mean?
This is the push-pull that teenagers have with parents.
Uh-huh.
Anyone who's ever been around a teenager is familiar with this.
Yes.
Teenagers need to push away uh-huh. their caretakers. They need to discover who they are separate, they discover their own identity and autonomy, and they need to say goodbye, good riddance, you don't matter to me, you're stupid, mm-hmm. I don't respect you,
yes.
because they need to kind of build who they are and eventually be able to leave the nest. It's a very necessary part of development. It's a very uncomfortable part of development for the teenager and the parent.
And yet, if the peers are cutting and using substances, and the boys who they're so attracted to because their maturation is coming in faster are controlling, sometimes abusive physically and emotionally, and they're pushing away the very people who can protect them.
Exactly. And they're turning to their peers.
Who are cutting and
pressures that they are.
Yes.
Yes. So what can we do?
Yeah.
And there is no easy answer to that. But there are a lot of suggestions. And I think one of the big ones is stay available. Stay available to your daughters, to your clients, and listen attentively and listen and take them seriously. Answer mm-hmm. them authentically and assure them repeatedly of their value. Mm-hmm. And there are specific things that we can encourage them to do and provide them with.
Now, as a hypnotherapist or a psychotherapist, will they take us more seriously than they'll take their mom, who obviously knows nothing?
Yes, the mom knows nothing.
The dad knows nothing.
Anyone outside the family is going to know something more than the parents.
Okay.
The parents are the most stupid.
Okay, so this is mm-hmm. very, very interesting and valuable information for us, because our adolescents will take us seriously,